have to feel obligated to say what you used to say. But you're now blocking the blessings of God that He has upon your life because they didn't mind when you were struggling. But God is faithful to His word, and if His people do what He said that you should do, there comes a season and that door closes and you struggle for a season, and now God says, now I want you to walk into the blessing. And see, many of us are falling because we thought that you struggle a little bit, you get a blessing a little bit. You struggle a little bit, you get a blessing a little bit. No, God said you had to struggle for a whole while, and now you need to get ready because all the blessings are coming at you. And now the underdog is now standing strong. You no longer have to depend upon those that once helped you. And now you know what they say. You thank you all that.
You earned it.
And if it wasn't for me, you wouldn't have that. You walking around in them shoes, but if it wasn't for me. The only reason you got that job because of me. And it'll throw it up in your face when God begins to elevate you. But God is ready to take those that were struggling. God is ready to take those. He said, listen, Jesus said, I didn't come for those that are already healed. I come for those that are sick. I come for those that will cry out to me. I come for those that are desperate. I'm looking for someone that's been in the muck and the mire and clay. Because my work works best in darkness. My work works best in darkness. I said, my work works best in darkness. Sister, can you hit the light for me for a little bit? Can you hit the light as well for me for a little bit? Now, as dark as it is in this room, your focus is on the light. And wherever the light is where we follow. You are the light of the world. In the midst of darkness, there is more darkness in here than there is light, but the light is drawing my attention. The light says, go over here. Even though it's dark in here, all my focus is on the light. Jesus has made all of us the light of the world. And when you walk in an arena, people want to know the direction to go. It's because of your struggle that your light has become so illuminated. And people are following the light. But if the light has lost its power, and if the light has also become darkness, where shall we go? But in the midst of your darkness and your struggles, you must become the light. And as you become the light, help me out, my brothers and sisters, your light becomes brighter. And what was darkness, help me out, brother and sister, has now become light. Now, it was because you refused to become darkness in a dark place. You refuse to take down your commandments and your commitment to God, and now everything that was around you that was dark has now become a light. And it was because you did not give up. And it was because you were the underdog. And you decided to stay with God even though you were the underdog, that now light has come. And I got news for you. Those that have come against you, those that have spoken against you, those that didn't believe anything was in you, are those that crucified you publicly. You don't allow them to apologize privately. That's why the Bible says that it's better to give than it is to receive. Because as long as you give, you will have. Can I have four volunteers that will come up front with me for a moment? Let's see how this thing works. It's better to give than it is to receive. Hallelujah. And thank you, Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Okay. Now, if I give my sister something and she gives it to a brother and he gives it to the brother and he gives it to the brother and the brother gives it back to the brother, it's better to give than it is. And he gives it back to the brother and the brother gives it to the sister. And the sister gives it to me, and I give it to the sister, and the sister gives it to the brother, and the brother 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 gives it to the sister, and the sister gives it to me, and we keep doing this, bless you all,
amen,
we'll never
amen
go lacking. But you know what happens? He says it's better to give than it is to receive. Because if you receive, it stops. But the flow of God, as long as we continue to give, I'm going to give you my love, and I need you to take my love and share it with another. And once you reach someone else, I want you to take that same love that I gave and give it to somebody else. And once you give it to someone else, they'll be encouraged to give it to someone else. And as long as we keep giving, it is more blessed to give than it is to receive. Because once we share with one another, the underdog is now going over. They will understand and they will recognize that the things that you have gone through in life was for a reason. You had to be in a dark room for a reason. If any of you remember when we took pictures back in the day, we didn't have cell phones,
right,
you had Polaroid cameras and things like that. You took the picture and it went through a process. It had to go in the dark room. And when it was in the dark room, you were curious to know what was happening with the picture. You wanted to get the picture out before it's time. But you could not pull it out before it's time. You had to wait for it to run its process and be developed. That is what's happening with us today. God has us in a dark room, and we're trying to get out of the dark room before the time. But God says, stay in the dark room and let me work on you. Because once I work on you and bring you out of the dark room, you shall come out as pure gold. And I'm telling you now, Satan is shooting his best shots at you, but I'm telling you, he's losing his grip. He no longer has the power on you that he once had. He is like a roaring lion. He's not that roaring lion in your life. The things that you may still struggle, I know we're not perfect, we have not arrived, but I'm telling you now that you are gaining ground. And I got news for everyone under the sound of my voice. We must recognize right now that every inch of kingdom soil will be contested. Every inch of kingdom soil will be contested. Every step that you take, Satan is trying to push you back. But I got news, if you'll only turn around, you'll see how far you've come from. You stop looking at where you used to go, and you get to look at where you come from. And when you look at where you come from, maybe you only cuss 10 times. You used to cuss like a sailor. Give God praise for that.
Soul Redeeming Ministries. Restore men and women back to the Lord through the Word, love, and Spirit of God. Come worship with us Sunday at 10 a.m. at the Rochester Auditorium Theater, 3rd floor, Suite 300.